Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you and welcome in our biology session. So today we will move for the next lesson in our biology, that is nothing but what? Microorganisms, friends and foe. Okay, so the name of the lesson is what? Microorganism, friend and foe. Now microorganisms means what and how they are useful to us and how they are harmful to us. All these things we are going to see in these lessons. Okay, so see, from the name only we can understand what we are going to discuss in the lesson. We are going to discuss about different types of the microorganisms. Also we are going to discuss about the there are the certain microorganisms which are friendly to us, which help us for the different processes, while on the other hand there are the certain microorganisms, those who are dangerous for us, or we can say they foe means what? Enemy. And enemy means they are not good for us. Okay, so in this way we are going to discuss about all the microorganisms. Some are useful, some are hazardous for us. Okay, so let's start for the lesson. Before going to see the different points, we will move for the first point of the lesson, that is nothing but what? Microorganisms. What is mean by microorganism? Yes, I know that you have already learned the definition of the microorganisms in your previous classes, but still let's revise what is mean by microorganisms. Okay, so let's see. The organisms that cannot be seen with the naked eye and can only be observed through a microscope are called microorganisms or microbes. Okay, see, from the name only we can say that micro means what? Small. Okay, so the organism, those who are very tiny, those who are very small, that we cannot observe them with our naked eyes, to observe them we have to use the microscope. Okay, so the organism, those who we cannot see them with our naked eyes and can observe with the help of the microscope only, that organisms are called as what? Microorganisms or microbes. Okay, so these microorganisms or the microbes are two types. We can say that some are unicellular or some are multicellular. Now unicellular means what? Some microorganisms are made up of only one cell, which are called as what? Unicellular, while some microorganisms are made up of so many cells, which are called as what? Multicellular. Okay, so this is about what? Microorganism. Now there are the so many scientists, those who are doing a lot of study in about the microorganisms. Okay, so to do the study about the microorganism, there is a separate branch of the science. Okay, and that branch of the science which deals the study of microorganisms is called microbiology. Okay, so in that microbiology, what happened? We can do the deeply study about the different types of the microorganisms. Okay, so see, the science that deals with the study of microorganisms is called microbiology. Okay, and the scientists who study the microorganisms are called as what? Microbiologist. Okay, so the scientists, those who are doing the study about the microorganisms, that scientists are called as what? Microbiologist. Okay, so this is all about microorganism. But the thing is that who invented or who said that the microorganisms are present on the earth, or they are present everywhere on the earth? Yes, so there was one great scientist was there, and his name was what? Antony van Leeuwenhoek. Okay, and he was a Dutch scientist. Okay, so the Dutch scientist Antony van Leeuwenhoek, he discovered that the microorganisms are present on the earth in the 1674. Okay, in the 1674 he discovered that microorganisms are present everywhere on the earth. And one more interesting thing about the microorganisms is that if we do the total weight of the earth, then 50% weight of the earth we can conclude or we can consider as the weight of the microorganisms. Okay, so it means what? There are the lot of microorganisms are present on the earth. Okay, So this is Dutch scientist Antony van Leeuwenhoek. He discovered the microorganism, the presence of microorganisms in the 1674. Okay. Now we'll move for the next point, that is where microorganisms live. Okay. So where the exactly microorganisms are living. So microorganisms can live everywhere on the earth. They can live in the air, they can live in the soil or in the land, and they can live in the water too. Okay, means they can live everywhere on the earth. Okay, also they can survive on the body of the human being, or they can survive inside the body of a living organism. So they can live inside the body of a living organism, also they can live on the body of the living organism, also they can live on the dead and decaying matter. And one of the very interesting thing about the microorganism is that they can survive in an extremely temperature, okay, or the extreme level of the temperature. They can survive in the desert also, they can survive in the drought also, in the polar region also, or in the marshy region also. Okay, so in this way the microorganisms can live anywhere in the different climatic conditions. Okay, so here we can say that what the microorganisms can live everywhere. One more thing about the microorganism is that some microorganisms are living separately, or they are living individually, okay, while some microorganisms are living in group, and that group of the microorganisms are called as what? Colonies. Okay, so the some microorganisms are living individually while some are making the groups and living, and that group of the microorganisms are called as what? Colonies. Okay, now the next one we'll discuss about that major groups of microorganisms. Just now we have said that there are the vast, or there are the numerous microorganisms are present on the earth. Okay, means so many microorganisms are present on the earth, but all these microorganisms are broadly get classified into the five major groups. And which are that major groups? Let's see the major groups of microorganisms. Okay, first one we can say that what? Bacteria. Okay, and the singular is what? Bacterium. Next one, viruses, singular we can say as virus. Next one is that algae, singular we can say as alga. Fourth one is fungi, singular we can call as fungus. Next one is that protozoa, and singular we can call as what? Protozoan. Okay, so in this way these are the five major groups of an microorganism, of a microorganisms. Okay,
so now let's move for the next point from the lesson. So in this point we will discuss each group of the microorganisms deeply. Okay, so we'll discuss the first group of the microorganisms, that is nothing but what? Bacteria. Okay, and singularly we can call it as what? Bacterium. Okay, so let's see about the bacteria. Bacteria are very small and the simplest unicellular microbes. Okay, so bacteria are the simple form of the microorganism, which is also the small and the simplest unicellular microbes. Okay, so it is the small, simplest and the unicellular microbes. Okay, next one, it can be vary in the size from 0.2 to 100 micron. Okay, so there is much small size of the bacteria is present. Okay, so what is the size? Can vary in the size from 0.2 to 100 micron. Okay, 0.2 to 100 micron. Okay, next one, this bacteria can form in the different shape. Okay, so the bacteria can form in the different shape. There are the different shapes of the bacteria. Let's discuss. Found in the different shapes, like first one is there bacilli. Okay, so the bacilli means nothing but what? Rod shaped bacteria. Okay, in the image you can see that how it is exactly, that is what? Rod shaped bacteria. Next one is there cocci. Okay, now cocci means what? Spherical bacteria. The cocci means what? What is the shape of that bacteria? The shape is what? Like a spherical bacteria. That also you can see in the image. Next one is there. Vibrio. Okay, now vibrio means what exactly? What is the shape of the bacteria? That vibrio bacteria is in a comma shaped. Okay, that is what, comma shaped bacteria. And the last one is that is spirilla. Okay, spirilla bacteria, that is what, spiral shape. Spiral means like a coiled shape. Okay, so these are the different shapes of the bacteria, that are what, bacilli, cocci, vibrio and spirilla. Okay, so these are the different shapes of the bacteria. It is the smallest, simplest and the unicellular microbes. The size ranges from 0.2 to 100 micron. Okay, and this bacteria is also the prokaryotic cell. Now prokaryotic cell means what? They don't have the well organized nucleus because of the absence of the nuclear membrane. Okay, so the bacteria are the prokaryotic cell, and it can found in the different habitat like air, water and the soil. Okay, so in this way, this is all about bacteria. Now we'll move for the next microorganism, and which is very important also, we can say that is nothing but what, viruses. Okay, so nowadays we are suffering from the one virus, that is we are telling as a corona virus. Okay, so this virus word every time we are telling these days. Let's discuss about what is mean by exactly virus. Okay, so viruses are considered as neither living nor non-living. Okay, they lies on the border line. Okay, they lies on the border line, or we can say that separates the living things from the non-living things. Okay, so the viruses are neither living nor non-living. They are on the border line. Okay, or we can say that they separating the living things from the non-living things. Okay, also we can say that the word virus means what? That is poisonous liquid. Okay, virus means what? Poisonous liquid. Next one, the viruses are the smallest microorganisms. So among the five major groups of the microorganism, the viruses are the smallest microbes. Okay, now the next one, their size ranges from, we can say that, 20 to 30 nanometer. Okay, so their size ranges from 20 to 30 nanometer. Next one is there, they lack a cellular structure. Okay, they don't have the proper cellular structure. They are lacking the cellular structure. Next one is there, very important point, that is they can multiply inside the cells of living organisms. Okay, so for the reproduction or to reproduce, they cannot reproduce individually. To reproduce, they should go inside the living cell. Okay, so they can multiply inside the cells of living organisms. Okay, they can multiply inside the cells of a living organisms. That cells can be bacterium also, plants also, or animals also. Okay, so in short, we can say that the viruses can get reproduced inside the living organisms. Okay, and that is the reason that viruses are called as what? Obligate parasites. Okay, that is the reason they are called as what? Obligate parasite. That is what it means, what? They cannot survive outside the host. Okay, they are living inside the host, we can say like that. Okay, so they cannot live outside the body of the host. To multiply, to reproduce, they are going inside the host body, then only they can get multiply or reproduce. Okay, and that is the reason they are called as what? Obligate parasite. Okay, next one is there, they have DNA and RNA coated with protein as their genetic material. Okay, so in the image you can see the structure of virus. Okay, so in that you can say in the upper side there is nucleic acid. Okay, it may be DNA or RNA. Okay, so they have DNA and RNA coated with protein as their genetic material. Okay, next one is there, a virus which infects a bacterial cell is called bacteriophage. Okay, so the virus which infect the bacterial cell, or the virus which infect the any living cell, that virus is called as what? Bacteriophage. Okay, so the virus which infect a bacterial cell is called bacteriophage or virus. Okay, so the virus which infect any cell, and that virus is called as what? Bacteriophage. Okay, so there are the certain or the common elements of the viruses are, we can say that common cold is there, influenza flu is there. Also there are the certain diseases which are happens because of the viruses, such as polio is there, AIDS is there, chicken pox is there, and now we can say that COVID-19 is also there. So all these are the different diseases which causes because of what? Viruses. Okay, so these is about virus, and today we have discussed about the microorganisms, where they are living, which are the main groups of the microorganisms. Also today we have discussed about the bacteria, and also we have discussed about the viruses. Okay, so this is all about today. This is the time to tell you goodbye. We will meet in the next video. Till then, bye.